there's nothing too special going on. That's why I made this video, to show you that when you have some good sounds, you don't really need to have any incredible mixing techniques to put it together. Then it's just a matter of balancing the volume, and then you'll be set for a good track. Hey guys, it's time for another Synth Saturday. And do you want to know how you can mix down this type of drop? Stick around and I'll show you how I've done it. So you might think this is a huge sound and it's really complicated to mix down, but actually if you have the right sounds, it's not that hard. And I'll just show you. We have the leads over here, and these are the same leads as from the tutorial. The only thing I added was a little bit of chords, and I used my virus for that. But you can use some other VST as well and just add a little chord layer and give the chords a little bit more body. Then I start off, of course, with just the chords and the kick, because just the melody and the kick, because the melody and the kick need to fit together. You might think there's a lot going on to mix down a kick and a melody, but there's nothing too special going on. If you have a good solid sound for your leads and a good kick, then you can just layer these two together and balance the volume out a little bit, and that's just gonna make the two glued together. So we have our kick channel, and just to show you, just kick channel over here is quite clean. It's just boosted a little bit in the ways that I wanted it to, but that's just a matter of preference. Sometimes your kick fit completely with your melody, and just a bandpass for my build-ups, and the lead channel, the lead bus is just boosting a little bit more of the highs, because that was missing after the tutorial. The highs were a little bit lacking, and I have that more often when I do my own mixdowns. So having this kick and this melody play together is really just all that needs to happen to get a good mix down. So let's solo them, and I'll just show you that this is 99% of the work done. And it's just a matter of balancing these volumes. You want to get your kick in there and place it at a certain point and think like, okay, this is too loud, maybe a little bit better, too quiet. And that's the way you just go through it till you find that sweet spot where the kick fits. And this is that sweet spot where that kick fits that melody. Yeah, after that, what I've done to create a little bit more space for the punch, with such a huge lead sound, sometimes the punch doesn't come through, is I layered this ghost punch in here. And what I've basically done is just take the same waveform and cut off all the way to the punch, made it unique and made it blue. That's the only change. So it's the same sound. And in here, we see that it doesn't have any output. This sound is just there to route to the bus. And over here in this limiter, it's just sidechaining that lead a tiny, tiny bit. Then after that, after we have these big sounds, which sound good, you still want to add something. And one of the first things I find myself adding is a crash, because the crash comes from the buildup. It comes slowly up. And having that crash on that first kick is really gonna make it feel like it's a finished build-up and it's a complete drop. So that's why I first always layer my crashes in there. And with the crash, it's over here. It's just a normal crash, having some highs boosted, so a little bit of compression and some reverb. But the main important thing is it's just a low cut. There's nothing too special to squeeze this crash in any way to get it to fit in the drop. It's just a low cut, and yeah, just playing around with the volume till it fits nice. So that's why I came up with this point for the crash. And then we have this melody and the kick playing together, and that sounds good. But then you got sounds from your breakdown as well. So maybe like this one. And the pluck just gives a nice drive. you want to have a little bit of the sound from your break, put it underneath that climax that you have, and that's just gonna fill up the space behind it. And then what I've done, you got the big sounds, you got your leads, you got your crash. It's just a matter of putting them in there, making them follow the chords, of course, because you want to have no false notes in there, no wrong notes. And you just, take that volume again and just put it in there in the right way. So this is the plug that I've shown you. This is the plug that I've shown you, and all that I've done over here is just a little bit of low cut and a little bit of high boost, just to give it a nice fit in that mix. And yeah, there's nothing too special going on. That's why I made this video, to show you that when you have some good sounds, you don't really need to have any incredible mixing techniques to put it together. Then it's just a matter of balancing the volume, and then you'll be set for a good track. Same with this pad over here. This pad has been playing through the entire track. But it's really wide, really making an atmosphere, and that's why I wanted to put it underneath the drop as well. So yeah, you just low cut that again. And it's just a matter of getting that volume right where you want it to be, and of course where it fits a little bit with that break as well. And yeah, that's all there is. It's just, if you have good sounds, it's not too difficult to do a good mix down, because if the sounds are right, it's just a matter of balancing the faders, and that's how you get this kind of drop. Thanks for watching, and I hope you learned something, and I hope to see you back soon again. Cheers!